Hello friends, welcome to Open Source DB Expert channel. Today, as a part of this video, we are going to cover what are the different types of NoSQL databases in the market. Okay friends, here we have some slides. Okay friends, normally in real time also how different types of NoSQLs will be there friends where we have to work. So we have to know what kind of NoSQL database we are working on. Okay friends, here I will show you what are the different types of NoSQLs. Okay, based on that we can decide which database we want to use based on our requirements. Okay, so before going to discuss types of NoSQL, first we will discuss what is NoSQL. NoSQL stands for not only SQL. Some people might call it not SQL. Originally it will refer all non-SQL databases. It can be non-relational databases. What are the non-relational databases? Those databases comes under NoSQL databases. Okay. NoSQL provides flexible schemas including scalable, high performance, high availability. Okay. Apart from that, you can store large amount of data. It can be terabytes of data, friends, where you can store including biometrical details, video files, audio file, PDF files, Word, everything you can store. Okay. There is no restriction where you can store the data in unstructured format. Okay, friends. Coming to history of NoSQL. Basically, NoSQL term was used by Carlo Storzi. This person has used this term NoSQL in the year 1998 for his open source relational database. It's not pure open source and it's not pure NoSQL database. It is Storzi NoSQL open source relational database. It's a combination of both RDBMS and NoSQL. Later, in 2010, Graph Database Neo4j also launched. Then in 2004 and 2005, Google has released Bigtable and CouchDB also has been released. In 2007 and 8, like Amazon Dynamo release. In 2008, for Facebook purpose, Cassandra also has been released. Okay, friends. So, 2009 onwards, it became most popular. In 2009 only, this term NoSQL was reintroduced. From 2010 onwards, all NoSQL databases became most popular in the market. Most of the companies, they are using NoSQL databases. Okay. Coming to major features of NoSQL. Okay. So, major features will be, this is non-relational database, right? It is schema free. So, unstructured data where you can store simple API, applicant programming interface also. Okay. Application programming interface. Distributed data where you can store performance, high availability, multimodal, concurrency, security, scalability, everything it will support. Friend. Okay, apart from that, better refer CAP theorem, friends, which we will call it as Beaver's theorem. I have already discussed about CAP theorem in my previous video. Please refer it. Because we will come to know what are the database comes under consistency, availability, partition, tolerance, it will be very easy to understand, friends. Okay. Now, first we will discuss what are the different types of NoSQL databases in the market. Okay, we have four major categories we have in the market NoSQL databases. Those are document oriented, key value store, column oriented, graph based. Okay, total four kinds of NoSQL databases we have in the market. Okay, now we will be discussing document oriented. Basically, document oriented and key value almost will store the similar data only, but here it will store the data in BSON format, like in the form of documents, friends. Major features will be a flexible schema, rich query language it will support, and it will support secondary indexes, and it will allow nested data structure. All those features it will be there in case of document oriented. What are the databases comes under document oriented databases like MongoDB, Couchbase, CouchDB? These databases comes under document oriented databases. When we can use, when we can't use. So, if you don't have any schema design or schema knowledge, directly you can use this one. Because here you can store unstructured data. But if schema is likely to change often also, you can use. Even for web analytics or real-time analytics also, you can use. Even for blogging platforms, e-commerce also, you can use. When it is not recommended, if data is highly related, and if efficiency is preferred over consistency, if you look into the CAP theorem, consistency and partition tolerance only it will support. Availability is compared to consistency and partition tolerance, it will be less. Okay, that's what. If you don't require partition tolerance, no problem. You can use consistency and availability. Okay, CAP, CAP theorem. Consistency and availability will be good in all the RDBMS. consistency partition tolerant will be good in MongoDB and Couchbase. Okay friends, then come to key value store. Key value store means in-memory databases. You can call it as both. Okay. In-memory databases features means fast read and writes. There is no indexes or non-key fields. Okay. It is basically simple design for storing user profiles and session information and all friends. Okay. For that purpose, you can use this in-memory or key value store databases. Okay. What are the databases comes under key value stores? Redis, right? These databases comes under key value stores. Okay friends, when you can use, when you have the data in bytes or string, and when data is not highly related, and if you want to perform CRUD operations, CRUD means create, read, update, delete operations. Okay, when it is not recommended, if you need any relationship among the data, or if you need any query by value, or it is not suitable for complex query. Okay friends, Redis and write databases comes under key value store databases. Okay, column oriented. So column oriented databases also there friends. This is third category where you can store the data based on column oriented. Basically famous databases will be Cassandra and Bigtable also is there. Okay friends, major features will be, it is very suitable for big data operations. It is very useful for storing wide rows, and even it will not wasted storage on null values. Okay, these are the major features. When you can use, when you can't use. If you want to store the event logging or content management system, logging platforms, expanding the data store, okay, you want to comparison of versioning, these are features if you need, you can use. If you want any column family design changes or key, basically key design itself is complex, okay, in that situation you can't use. So example databases will be Apache HBase and Cassandra. These two databases are famous in the market. Coming to graph-based. Graph-based means like where you can store the data in graphs. So if you want to store the data in graphs, this is perfect database where we'll get the features like highly related data, where data will store in nodes and edges. Okay. Quick graph traversers. Okay. These are the features we'll get. Okay, friends. When you can use, when you can't use. Basically, for location-based services, including like your data more like a graph for routing dispatch purpose, you can use. If it is involving graph only, it is better, you can use. But it does not scale well horizontally. And updating all subset of data entities, it will be difficult. Okay. Example databases will be Neo4j and OrientDB. These two databases famous in the market. Okay. Graph database. So, according to Stephenson, he has again classified these databases into subcategories. Okay, here you can see this is not that much important. If you want to skip, you can skip this category. Okay, basically only we have four kinds of NoSQL databases: document oriented, key value, then column oriented, graph based. Okay, but this Stephenson, he has again classified into subcategories. Okay. This is not that much important, just I am going to discuss. Okay, key value cache, these databases are like Couchbase, okay, Memcache, Redis, these are the famous databases in the market. Key value store means we have ArangoDB, even Couchbase, Redis. So based on CAP theorem friends, you want consistency availability means it will comes under one category. If you want availability partition tolerant, it will be under different category. If it is availability partition tolerant, it will comes under different category. Okay friends, see here you can see duplicates. Couchbase is supporting for key value store, even key value cache. So based on features, it will get changed. Okay friends, then key value store, eventually consistency means you can use Oracle NoSQL server is there. I mean Oracle NoSQL, not SQL, Oracle NoSQL database, Dynamo, Rake, these it will support. Then key value store with oriented. So famous market in the market, LMDB, Memcached DB, like FunctionDB, InfinityDB are there. Tuple store you want to store, then Apache River, Giga Spaces will be there. Object databases you have in the market like JoboDB, first, and apart from that Objective DB, these are the databases. Document store will be famous in the market, like we have been discussed, Red MongoDB, Couchbase, CouchDB, these are famous databases in the market. Okay, wildcard store, it will be famous in the market. What are the databases we have? Cassandra, Amazon DynamoDB, Apache HBase, Hypertable, these are the famous databases comes under wide column store. Native multimodal databases, these are different categories where ArangoDB, CosmoDB, OrientDB, MarkLogic, these are the databases comes under this category. Okay friends, so basically these are the subcategory databases, but as per best practice, most of the people will consider only these four databases only. Okay, if anybody will ask what are the different types of NoSQL, we can simply say we have mainly four different types of NoSQL databases in the market, which are document oriented, key value store, column oriented, and graph based. Okay, what are the famous databases comes under document oriented? MongoDB, Couchbase. Comes under key value store, Rake and Redis. Comes under column oriented, HBase, Cassandra. Okay, even DynamoDB also, Amazon DynamoDB. Okay, comes under graph based, Neo4j, OrientDB. Okay friends, these are the main four categories we have in the market, friends. Okay friends, I hope you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe and activate bell icon for more updates. Okay friends.